Hello again, I'm Larry Hamilton. Welcome to my YouTube painting channel. Thank you for watching. Today we're going to do a still life. Many students in my class have suggested we do a still life, and even some people on YouTube have asked why I haven't done still life. So I'm going to do one today for you, and it will be the painting that we do in our May 21st oil painting class. And hopefully you like it. I have a setup here that I'll show you. I have a camera on the setup. I have a camera on my palette and one on the canvas. So that's my usual setup. So today it's pretty basic. We have three main objects. We have something like a teapot, a coffee cup, and a little vase with some little plant in it, and then some magnolia leaves on the bottom, over a little cloth on the table. So hopefully it will not be too difficult for us to get through. I have a photo of it that I'm using as well, and I'll show you that. And I also have a sketch on my canvas today. Again, still lifes can be a little difficult because of the angle that you look at them, depending on where you are in a room when you have a live setup. The perspective can be different for every student in the room. So angles and the ellipses and the way the objects look on canvas could be different in every student if they're actually looking at the live setup. So anyway, I have a drawing already done based on a setup and a photograph that I've taken. And I'll explain to you that we're going to use a 11 by 14 canvas again. I have it toned with gray gesso as usual, and I have the sketch put on with my white charcoal pencil. And we'll be using the Bob Ross brush set again that I've mentioned before, and I will show those when I edit the video. Basically, we have a landscape brush and a fan brush, have a small rigger, a painting knife, and we have a couple of Dick Blick scholastic brushes that are one's a Filbert and one's a Bright. The paints we're using, I'll go over those again very quickly. The standard Bob Ross set with one added paint have titanium white, phthalo blue, Prussian blue, midnight black, Van Dyke brown, dark sienna, alizarin crimson, sap green, cad yellow, yellow ochre, Indian yellow, bright red, and Grumbacher ultramarine violet. So that's our paints. Have the canvas ready to go. I have a little liquid white I'm going to use in some spots here. I'm not going to use a lot of liquid white today. This is going to be pretty much on canvas as we see it, without a lot of liquid white. But just to get some of the paint flowing, I'm going to put a little liquid white here in the background. We're going to start with the background, and it's going to be a very dark background, as you can see from the photograph and from the setup, that we're going to want mostly dark paint back here, but I'm going to just put a little liquid white to make the paint flow a little smoother and make it go a little farther. Our big teapot here in the center is going to be white, so I'm going to put a little liquid white in there just to color the canvas a little bit. Try to preserve some of my sketch so I know where the coffee cup overlaps with the teapot. And preserve that right there. That's a good, put a little bit on this handle, not much. Yeah. You're seeing me do this for the first time. I have not painted this painting before, so you'll be able to experience my mistakes and hopefully my corrections. And when we get finished, we'll have a nice still life here. I have a vase back here that's a very different shape. It's sort of has a tip on it that's sort of narrow and pointed, but it has this very beautiful red color, almost ruby red, with the light shining through it. It really has some nice shadows and some nice see-through elements of it. All right, that's good enough for that. Let's get going on the background here a little more now. I'm gonna just keep this brush without making any, without washing it out. I'm going to start picking up some midnight black and maybe a little bit of Van Dyke brown. I'm going to start just putting in some dark back here. It's going to turn gray on me, of course, because it's got a lot of white on the canvas, and I'll have to probably come back and put a lot more color in. But I want it to be the background is actually a black a panel that I bought at a hobby store that is meant for setting up still lifes. It's a, I don't know, it's about 4 feet tall and has little wings on its side of it, and it's used for just blocking off an area so you can really focus on the elements in your still life painting. And so I'm putting some blue in here, putting a little bit of Prussian blue, a little bit of black, a little bit of Van Dyke brown. This is a little cool. I can warm it up by putting in some alizarin and dark sienna over here. I don't want a lot of stuff in this background. I'm really not trying to make it look like wallpaper or anything like that. It's just going to be a sort of a nondescript area back here. Float the colors around, mix the colors up, get a nice sort of pleasing backdrop. One needs to be darker. Let's throw some violet in here. There we go. See what that does. Okay, let's see here. Needs to be darker for sure. Pick up a little phthalo blue. That's a dark, good dark color. More violet, Van Dyke. There's some really dark. Phthalo blue really puts a dark color in here. Paint behind this vase, or this, it's a... down here like this. I want this red to show up down here on this lower level table. So we'll just mix these colors together, throwing in alizarin, violet, Van Dyke, dark sienna. Just a nice abstract mix of colors here. Try to get around this. This vase actually goes in here. A little more back here. Maybe I'll try a little of this regular red in here, see if I can get some brighter color. I want something to echo the red that's going to be in this cloth on the top of this table. Okay. I do have some light that's shining down. The light, actually, light source is up here, and it's pointing down toward that ruby red vase. The black, the Bob Ross black paint is not super black. It's it sort of turns gray or blue-gray on you. Okay, let's see here. I need white in there. I need dark. I'm going to pick up my filbert brush because I need a smaller brush here to try to get these some of this background in the smaller places here. So along in here, actually this vase goes something like this. I'm kind of painting over my leaves now, losing them a little bit. Try to leave room for this top of this teapot here. It's going to be really a sharp V point in there. So I'm just down here. So that's white. This is going to be red. Okay, this is dark. Okay, trying to make sure I know where my darks are and where my lights go. This is a nice rounded object. Darken some of this down a little more in here. I want it really. When I do this in class, I may not put as much liquid white on this canvas just because it's turned so light on me. I had to use more paint anyway to get it darker. I'll take some of this red, pull some in here. Bright red has going to reflect a little bit of this color of this ruby red vase that we've got these flowers in. Okay, so I've used quite a bit of paint here getting this background in, a non-distinct background. All right, step back, take a look at that and see if I'm happy with it. Okay, let's stop with that. Clean out our brushes. Okay, now I think I'll start with this ruby red vase back there, if I can create a good color for that with my Bob Ross paints. And I'm going to take some titanium white and some alizarin and see if I can get a nice ruby red color here. Almost alizarin and white will do it. So back in here we've got this, it's almost too pink right there. A little more alizarin in there. The vase comes all the way down. And actually wraps a little bit behind this coffee cup. Actually comes down as far as goes behind this leaf. There's a magnolia leaf here on the table, so this vase sort of goes down right behind it. Something like that. Try a little bit of this other red in there. See if I can mix up the colors a little bit. Get a along the side of this coffee cup. All right. To start. All right, now we have this other. Let's see if I can get a interesting color for it. I don't know. Too much blue. It's actually a right here, have more of this some reds, picking up some blues, making some lavender colors in here. Not lavender, but sort of a red that's got some shadow in it. Brighten some of this up. It's going to be really more in the light over here. Okay, that's the cloth that goes underneath, and it goes over here. I'll well put the rest of it in while I've got this red in my brush under this magnolia leaf in this area here, and then even back here some. Down just a little with some blue. It's too far down. Okay, let's stop with that right about in there. Over here like this. So hopefully I'm getting the outline of my coffee cup and my teapot. It needs to be a little bit like this. There we go. Looks a little better. Okay, let's put a few streaks in here like this. These green. Okay. All right. Making progress here. Okay. Put a few marks in here that sort of indicate it's not just totally flat. Okay, so much for my filbert for a while. Get this thing cleaned out. And take a look at this teapot back here. Actually, I think I want to come back in and before I get rid of this filbert, I'm going to come back and put some colors in here to gray this red down. The back right here, there's a, you can actually see the through the vase, you can actually see the background. Hopefully I'll be able to make that look right. It's got some really dark color in there. So I'm darkening it down enough to there's a interesting shadow under here. Gives the bottom of this some roundedness. So you can actually see through it. I hope that looks like you can see through that vase to the background a little bit is the idea. More darks up here. Leave that edge there. Something like this. We'll come back and put some highlights on it after a bit, but start with that. Pull this color back here in the background some more. Clean out my brush a little bit. All right, we'll stop for a minute on that and see if, step back, take a look. Okay. A lot of this under here is shadow. Got these leaves that maybe I can see if I can get a little leaf color here. A little bit of sap green, a little bit of black, and a little bit of yellow ochre. Give me this. So this color for these magnolia leaves here. Black. One leaf. Let's work on these other two and get something, some base color laid down for those. We got one back here that's pretty good size. Something like that. A little bit longer, maybe. Here's a black sap green and a yellow ochre. black and yellow ochre will make a nice olive color. If you want a little more green in it, just put a little sap green in it, is all I do. If I get some more paint on here, there. Something like this. All right, just a couple of leaves there. So, got my vase going, my cloth on the front. Okay, that's looking pretty good. I've got a bunch of other leaves. I don't know if I want to put them all in now or not, but I'm going to start putting in a few things that look like some leaves up here. If you pick up a little yellow, cad yellow, to brighten some of these up, as they are closer to the light up here. Just some of these, some ideas here for leaves, petals of this plant that's sitting inside this vase. Something like that for starters. We'll come back and refine that a little more later. All right. All right. Clean out the filbert again. Now, let's see if we can start work on this teapot. I'm going to pick up my Scholastic Blick wash brush. It's really a watercolor brush. It's a nylon brush. I don't think I mentioned that earlier, but I'm going to start working on this teapot. It's not just pure white. It's got some blue reflections in it. It's got some pink in it. I'm using titanium white, and I've got some the white that's on here. Got a little this pink in it. There's some pink reflection from the bottom down here. And it gets darker over here. I'm just going to paint this in. Titanium. Now the strokes I'm using are following the shape of this rounded pot. So they're curved this way and this way. And it helps make it look like it's definitely rounded. Give room for this little coffee handle here. It's actually white, but I'm going to make it sort of gray so that it overlaps the teapot here. Okay. Some more. Get some really nice sharp edges with this kind of a brush. Probably a purist wouldn't use this kind of brush, but right now I'm just working with it. It's really, really bright. I want to start putting in some of the shadow colors here. So let me put that lid on first up here and see if I can pop this guy in. Picking up paint underneath. It's got a nice little circular top on it here. For starters, everything on the left side is going to be brighter and have some paint sticking up. And as it moves around, it gets some more shadow, and we start picking up some little darker color here in this area. Shadows are what make it look three-dimensional. All right through here. Feather this in, put a little, some shadows under here. Give the lid some shadow. Pick up a little more of this pink. There's actually some interesting reflection of this pink back in here. Coming off of the cloth that it's laying on. Feather it in there very softly. Make a nice gradiated. So I'm trying to make it look like there's, it's very rounded. A little hard to see on the camera probably, but probably need to make it a little darker just for the benefit of the video here. But so I'll put one more, a little darker here than maybe it needs to be, but it's not showing up too well on the video. So let's put a little more dark in here. And so you get the light, light's coming from this way, so it's hitting on this white teapot, and we also have light coming through this pink vase, a ruby vase, and it's sort of adding a little bit of a color here. Down below it gets a little darker because it's in shadow, and we're getting some reflection up from the table top as well. So this is not truly not a white, totally white object here. Try to blend it, try to make it curve, make the brush strokes curved. All right, even though that's pure white, and we're not painting it pure white, and it looks like I have a slight out of roundedness here. Maybe this needs to be a little bit when I go down and look at this on the back and look at it through the camera, I see a different view. And some artists, at least one artist I know, will take a mirror and look at it backwards to see mistakes in perspective or the roundness of an object. And what I do with a camera is about the same thing. I go back and look, take a look at what the camera is recording, and I can see the mistakes. Okay, let's feather this out a little bit more. Spending quite a bit of time on this, but that's okay. Oh, we have a the neck over here as well that I've kind of left out, but it goes right in here. Okay. That, okay, that's going to be gray. Okay. And we have a handle on the right side that I've totally covered up with my paint. So I'm going to see if I can just sort of lay it in here. Something like that. First pass. It's a little thicker than that. Pick up the white highlight here and there. White highlight on the inside of this handle here, and it's highlight on top here. So putting the highlight on top of the handle and the inside helps show that it's rounded as well. It sort of blends in with this base here, smooth that out a little bit. Can't see where it's connected. Same up here, it sort of connects in this way. All right, now a little more gray around the. I actually have some shadow back in here where this. A lip actually this thing sits down in, and I'm going to try to reflect that if I can. Maybe too subtle for you to see on the camera, but up here it looks about right. Maybe need to make it a little darker for you. Just adding a little midnight black to this white that's on here that makes it sort of turn to a gray. Okay, we've got to probably have a little shadow under this here, like that. All right, let's stop on that. All right. Now our teacup, start back here with this guy and put in some color. Just using my white again. It has more shadow in it because it's definitely away from the light a little bit, at least down inside here what you can see. So we'll make it a little darker. Leave the tip, leave the edge bright because the light is hitting it. We'll leave this front edge white right in here. Actually, it has a little gold rim around it. I might want to come back and put some gold on that. So over here, we're going to start coming down now. And this has a little, actually a little flower pattern and some blue in it. I don't know if I want to put much blue in there. I'll get it too dark. Those blues just sort of eat your paint up. Much. And this cup has a little gold rim around the bottom of it, even down here. Something like that. The bottom is even a little darker. A little black, a little more black, a little more blue. Picking up some of that red in my brush. Don't like that. Go back and get some more white. One more black. Okay, let's step back, look at it in the video recorder, see what it looks like. All right, we're seeing some nice reflection. The light is hitting here and it fades out to a little darker color back here, which is nice. I like that. The bottom is really pretty much under shadow down here, so we'll leave it like this for now. Let me put in this other handle. See, I need a little more black paint, I think. My black paint. Seem to never have enough midnight black. All right. Now, okay, this cloth underneath is a white fabric under here, so I'm gonna need more white. So I think I'll clean out this brush, get some of that black out of it, and let's start more titanium white here. Use a little liquid white maybe and make it run a little better. Get it on here. Okay, we get a little white in here. More liquid white. I think that's probably a better way to put it on here to get it on fast. Pick up some green, wipe that out of the brush. More white. Actually, it goes up here like this. And we have some too much red in there, so I'll just take my paper towel and wipe that out. This is a cloth that's laying at an angle like this, so the right side should be up that way. So let me get that out of there. Come back, get some more white. Fill it in like this. There. Okay, so now we're starting to see the base. The bottom of it have some nice overlaps. And I just kind of filled this in with liquid white and titanium white. Keep wiping that out of the brush. This white gets eaten up by the red back there. All right. And there's actually a fringe. This red cloth has a fringe on it. Kind of hard to see, but we'll try to put that in with some dry brush in a minute. And I'm feeling that there's, we need to have some stronger color over here. This background is, it is really all black, but it needs to have either darker or something else going on over there. I don't have my handle in for my coffee cup yet either. Let me go ahead and put that in now, since I've got this white and sort of gray color in my brush. Here, I'll come back and get some more of my black. Try to make this handle actually overlaps, comes in like this and comes around like that. Yeah, so it overlaps the coffee pot, or teapot, I guess we call it. And I want it darker on the back side here. If I can get it darker, a little bit too dark maybe. It has to stand out. It has to be darker than the white behind it, or you won't see it. And we'll do the same thing here with the highlight color. We'll come back and get some pure white. So we'll put a white top on here. Up there, and a little white right in here. Okay, that helps make that handle stick out and show some shadow. All right, that's a lot of the basics, I think. I don't want to mess with it too much. I'll mess it up. See if I can get a little dry brush on this red here and see what this looks like. We've got a little fringe that sort of sticks out here like this. You about have to hit it once and go back and get more paint. Something like that. A little fringe here. A little fringe back here. All right, that may really not, you may not be able to see that at all on the camera, I don't know. The idea is to sort of give it a soft, kind of a dry brush edge right there. Okay, not too much more to do there. How are we doing on time? Oh, 50 minutes, okay. All right. There are some textures in this cloth underneath that I want to sort of emulate here if I can, so it's not just all one boring white section. There's actually a full-blown pattern in there with swirls and everything else, but I'm not going to try to emulate that or try to even paint it. It would be, if I were going to take 8 hours to do this painting, I would probably do something like that. But for a painting that I want to get completed in an hour to an hour and a half, you have to sort of decide how much embellishment you're going to put in, how much time do you have, how long will people watch this video before they get bored. Okay, so that toned that down a little bit. It's not competing now with the center of interest, which is this teapot. I see when I look at it reverse that I have some shadow deficiency still in this teapot. It needs to come up higher, actually, like this. I need to make that more. Actually, it comes up this high there. I've been using this watercolor brush with nylon bristles for a lot of this detail work here. And okay. Underneath here, we gotta have some more dark. There's actually, now that I look at it closer, there's a little base underneath this teapot that sort of sticks out like right in here. Something like that. A little wider than that, maybe. There. Add some shadow under it. Much. So these shadows are what help make this thing stand out as well. So I'm going to put in, just using my midnight black here and sort of blending it in. Goes all the way back into here. There is a rim of dark under here that sort of pull it up, make it blend with what's there. We have a shadow. Way to take this red and gray it down. I'm going to add some sap green to my red, to make the shadows under here. Gives it sort of a grayish, reddish color, or reddish green color, I should say, which is a more appropriate color for this shadow because shadows really are the color of the objects that you're painting over with. They're just grayed down. So, even though I was using black a while ago, this is a better shadow color here. It's alizarin crimson and sap green together. And I'm gonna make this stand out. have a little shadow under here. I already have a little bit of a shadow there. I have a shadow coming out actually over here. All the way around, this shadow goes around this coffee cup base. It's a dark shadow in there. These all go along here. There's even some shadow down here from that coffee cup. Actually turns out of, out of the light. There's a little lip here on the table where that turns out of the light slightly. Okay. Over here we've got a lot of more dark. There, we got some under here. All right, step back, take a look. Are we getting some depth and definition in there? I definitely can see through the ruby vase, is what I wanted to do. This shadow color here is a little irregular, but I'm going to blend it just slightly. All right, leave that, leave that. Let's try just a little more over here. I mean, it's a little too dark, too green actually. See, I think I've got the pot just about right. The teapot looks like it's got enough form. Probably could use just a bit of shadow here on the right side, like right in here. Make sure you don't get it too dark. Make that handle stand out slightly. Better. A lot to making something look three-dimensional on canvas. And the more specific an object you have, like a teapot, where people know what it looks like, the more work you have to do to make it right. Same problem with doing portraits. People know what faces look like, and you have to work very hard to make them look accurate. I see a little more shadow under this cup here. There's a little wedge of dark right here, if I can get it in. Right in there. And this right side should be a little darker than the left side. Something like that. Very subtle differences. Very hard to notice, but they're put them in, it makes it look all that much better. Red and green together make this shadow under here better, darker. Okay. About ready to go take on these leaves back here. Darken this up back here, make sure this stands out. All right. So the leaves that I've started putting some in here need to be better defined. And I'm going to start just taking some of this cad yellow, try to go over it and mix it with that green that's there where I have some. See if I can make them stand out a little better. Something like that, putting like a highlight on them here. Just using cad yellow over some of the green that's there. And some of these are a little larger than others, some are a little smaller. So the highlight should go on top. One really nice leaf like here. Let's lay it like that. More. I'm going to put some connectors in there to hold it together. Need more green. Okay, let's see here, I get some more yellow, see if I can highlight just a little more of this. Up here should have some very nice highlights on it. Yeah, something like that. Put a few highlights down here on this magnolia leaf. Got a few more over here on this guy. I'm just using cad yellow now on top of this. And make sure the lower level's darker underneath. So I'm using that shadow color, some of my sap green and alizarin for under here. Okay. These shadow colors should blend, if you can make them blend together with the object they're shadowing. Helps it a little bit. All right. I think it's time to get my script liner out now and see if I can get some thinner and sort of a light green here. I want to put the stems here on these up here on these leaves. They've got to be kind of connected together. Thinner. Sap green, a little white, maybe even a little alizarin to gray it down a little bit, to gray the green down. Alizarin will gray sap green down, sap green will gray down alizarin. So just kind of connect some of these leaves together with some crooked lines. I'm going to try something inside this vase to see if I can make it look like there's roots sticking down inside the vase. I'm adding a little yellow ochre to this green mixture, and down inside here there's stuff going on inside this vase. Usually things underwater or in water tend to sort of take an ochre look to them. Not too many. Let's get a light color here and sort of connect things together. All right. Now, that helps. See if I can do a little fine tuning on this coffee cup. Let's put in, while I got this color in my brush, go back to these magnolia leaves and see if I can put a few more highlights on those to make them look more like their leaves, like something down the middle, like a split in the leaf. Over here, a similar split maybe. Something like that. When you have a lot of time you can spend on this, you can do a lot better job, I'm sure, but I'm trying to do this in around an hour to an hour and 30 minutes. So I always know how to do it better. Sometimes taking longer will help. Sometimes taking longer ruins it. All right, so much for that. Now let's see if we can somehow get a gold color here. I'm not sure what I'm going to use for that, but I'm going to pick up some of my yellow, maybe a little bit of this red, and start with an orange and start adding some white to that and see what happens. Getting a pink. So I don't have an orange on my palette, or a gold on my palette. So I'll just keep working here until I get something that looks like I want it. What I want to do is put a rim around the top of this coffee cup. It's not really gold, it's more pink, but there's enough yellow or enough red in this, the surroundings, that gold lip on this cup tends to pick up some of those reds anyway. So let's see if we can put a little lip right here. Probably going to have a lot of trouble seeing this on the video. A little more yellow in there. Yeah, that'll make it more gold. Plenty of thinner on this to get a nice runny texture on this script liner. I'm not putting it all the way around. Sort of hit and miss. Just enough to make the eye say, oh, there's a gold rim around that thing. Something about like that. A little bit in here, like a little more. The eye will fill the rest of that in. You don't have to paint it all. Just a touch back here. All right, now. Oh, let's see, there's no gold there. All right, so let's leave that. I'm gonna see if I can put in just a semblance of some flowers. There's some pink roses that are setting on top of this coffee cup. Again, this is something I could leave out, or I can try to put it in. So I'm gonna use my script liner with a lot of thinner again and see if I can just kind of draw in a couple roses here, pink roses. Start out with this color here, and we'll put in maybe two little flowers here. Come back and get some more darker red. This alizarin. Darken it up with these two red colors. Alizarin and bright red. And I'll put some shadows in there, and these shadows will help make it look like there are little roses sitting there on the side of this thing. Hopefully. Something like that, not too much. And then while I got the script liner going, go back and get some sort of greenish color here for some leaves and stems around there. Something like that. It's actually a little blue, sort of a bluish background on that, which is kind of interesting. So I'm going to pick up some Prussian blue with some titanium white with a lot of thinner in it. Get myself a little bluish color and see if I can sort of, that's not blue enough. Almost looks like the gray that's on there, so let's get a little bluer. So I'm painting a very detailed thing on top of this coffee cup. Smooth it out, sort of make it abstract a little bit. And that's all we need to do. All right, step back, get away, take a look. Okay, still think I need something on that upper right. This upper right looks too too boring to me. Okay, so what are we gonna do? I'm gonna get my big old landscape brush. And pick a color. I'll take some of this reddish color I got here. Throw some of that in there. Sort of echo this red colors coming from the, and then maybe pick up some lavender to give myself some darker textures in there. Make this corner, I'm gonna make that upper corner a little darker with violet. Okay, I took out some of those small brush strokes from that filbert. So I have a nice change of color here from now. Maybe that's a little better. I don't have such small strokes in there. All right, I've been going a little over an hour here. Let's just put some more I think that helps balance it out just a little bit. don't want to be so heavy over here and not have something over there. So that's the reason for that. Okay, I think I'm going to stop before I make it any worse. And hopefully you like this. And yes, I think I'm going to stop for now. Okay, so that's all I'm going to do on this painting. And could do a lot more. Could spend several hours painting this, but I know you'd get bored watching any more of me on this particular painting. So if you're my oil painting class on May 21st, give this a try and look at it, and that's what we're going to do. And if not, give it a try and let me know how you do. Send me any questions. I'll have this on Facebook, or on YouTube, rather, in a couple days when I get it edited. And until I see you again, this is Larry Hamilton saying so long for now. So long. Bye.